Greetings, my name is Ryan Nix. I'm a solutions architect with Amazon Web Services. Let's take a moment and talk about OpenShift Virtualization on Red Hat OpenShift Service, AWS, ROSA. ROSA is a managed version of OpenShift where Red Hat SRE team members manage the OpenShift environment for the customer so that the customer can focus on what is important to their business and not necessarily have to worry about all the lights and bulbs around keeping things up and running. Essentially, same as other AWS services, we cater for the undifferentiated heavy lifting and customers can focus on what is important to their business. Now, what is OpenShift Virtualization? OpenShift Virtualization is an add-on module that can be put onto OpenShift and you can run traditional virtual machine workloads in combination with your containerized applications as part of your broader modernization strategy. Let's zoom in and have a look at that in a little bit more of a practical sense. So traditionally, if you look at managed OpenShift, or in this case, the Red Hat OpenShift service on AWS managed OpenShift, there would be a control plane and that would be made up of a collection of control plane nodes or EC2 instances. In ROSA Classic Edition, these would appear in the customer's account. More recently, with ROSA hosted control plane, we've shifted the control plane out of the customer account and we've placed it into a service team account. Very similar to what you see with other AWS services like EKS or ECS. The actual compute, the actual worker nodes, these are the nodes where the customer's applications will be running. These will exist inside a separate account inside the customer's account. So these are my worker nodes, and on those worker nodes we're going to see all of the customer's applications. These are the container workloads for the modernized apps, typically microservices that the customer has brought into OpenShift. When we bring OpenShift virtualization into the picture, we take a operator from the operator hub and we install OpenShift Vert into my environment, and this will typically be done on a separate set of compute nodes. These are going to be bare metal instances on AWS, and my virtual machines are going to run on these nodes over here. Notice over here, everything is split in threes. So what we do is we will typically spread this across multiple AWS availability zones. In so doing, we combine the resilience model of OpenShift with the resilience model of AWS. So if something had to happen in, with a component of OpenShift, its resilience model would compensate for that, correct for it. If something had to happen to an availability zone, we've still got the other two availability zones maintaining resilience for the customer. Let's take a moment and zoom in on one of these bare metal instances. So what we typically have is we would have a persona. This might be a developer, this might be an admin, and they're going to be interacting with this OpenShift cluster via the OpenShift API. The API in turn talks to the operator modules of OpenShift virtualization. Let's zoom in on this bare metal instance. So this is a AWS bare metal instance. Running on top of that bare metal instance, we're going to have a operating system that underpins this node. This would typically be Red Hat Enterprise Linux or Red Hat Enterprise, Red Hat Core OS, sorry. Typically in my experience, it's Core OS, it's no longer RHEL. Running on top of that, we've got all of the OpenShift components itself that make this node part of a broader OpenShift cluster. Included that is the Kubernetes components. So we will see a kubelet running on top of that operating system. Then we've got all of the components that the cluster itself and the OpenShift virtualization operator would have talking to the components over here. So one of those components sitting over here is a virtualization controller, and the API that my developer is talking to would actually interface with that virtualization controller over here. The virtualization controller, it basically extends the APIs to cater for an additional layer of APIs that are relevant to the virtualization stack. On my node itself, we're going to find a couple of components, one of them being the virtualization handler. We will see another component called the virtualization launcher. And what we will see is the virtualization controller, the vert handler, and vert launcher working in tandem with each other. Let's zoom in for some of the components underneath. The virtualization handler is essentially a daemon set running inside my node that facilitates working with virtual machines. My virtual machine launcher is responsible for the actual launching placement of the actual VMs or the actual underlying Kubernetes pods that facilitate my virtual machines. These are all going to run as containerized workloads inside my OpenShift environment. Interfacing with the virtualization launcher, we're also going to have libvirtd, and that is going to interact with the launcher, and all of these are components of that OpenShift virtualization operator that we're installing via the operator hub inside OpenShift. And then finally, we will have the actual virtual machine itself over here. All of these are going to be container workloads running inside my OpenShift environment. What does this mean for customers? So when I first looked at this, I asked the question of, like, why would we intermix virtual machines with container workloads? In essence, this is a customer who is on a modernization strategy. They're taking their legacy technical debt footprint, they're modernizing that into potentially microservices on containers on OpenShift. They've invested in OpenShift. However, their business may still have a large portion of the business running as workloads on virtual machines. Maybe some of those are on legacy operating systems that are not available on AWS. You can't easily bring them into, say, EC2. There potentially is workloads that the customer intends to modernize in future but isn't going to get around to them in the short term. And with their existing investment in OpenShift, there's a desire to consolidate their virtual machines and their container workloads into one platform. In this case, add OpenShift virtualization onto OpenShift, and I can have those virtual machines running in OpenShift side by side with the workloads that my developers have already modernized, and then gradually convert them through the process. The OpenShift virtualization, as I said, very, very simply, it's a free add-on. It costs nothing. There's no licensing ramifications. There's no additional subscriptions. And it runs on top of your existing OpenShift investment. So what you have the ability to do, go to your OpenShift cluster, open up the operator hub, install the OpenShift virtualization operator. We will have to add in potentially another machine pool into the environment to cater for some bare metal nodes. Once those nodes are part of the cluster, you can either start creating virtual machines, but much more likely we're going to see customers pull existing virtual machines from a virtualization stack that they're trying to consolidate away from. And one of the things that you can take advantage of is the Red Hat toolkit, the OpenShift migration toolkit for virtual machines, which will connect to your existing virtualization stack and help pull those VMs into your OpenShift environment, where you can, over time, modernize them into containerized workloads running on top of OpenShift. I hope this gives you a good glimpse of what is under the hood with OpenShift virtualization, and thank you for joining me.